noche abandonada. Otro día pide turno. Yo camino hacia tus pasos, yo camino hacia él, sin rumbo. Camino hacia él, sin rumbo. Sin rumbo.
the time, he says, people were not born separate from each other. They were born entwined, kind of coupled with each other. So there were boys attached to boys, and there were girls attached to girls, and of course, boys and girls together, in a wonderfully intimate ball. And back then we had 8 limbs. There were 4 on top, 4 on the bottom, and you didn't have to walk if you didn't want to. You could roll, and roll we did. We rolled backwards and we rolled forwards, achieving fantastic speeds that gave us a kind of courage. And then the courage swelled to pride, and the pride became arrogance. And then we decided that we were greater than the gods, and we tried to roll up to heaven and take over heaven, and the gods' alarm struck back, and Zeus, in his fury, hurled down lightning bolts and struck everyone in 2 into perfect halves. So all of a sudden, couples who'd been warm and tight and wedged together were now detached and alone and lost and desperate and losing the will to live. And the gods, seeing what they'd done, worried that humans might not survive or even multiply again, and of course they needed humans to give sacrifices and to pay attention to them, so the gods decided on a few repairs. Instead of heads facing backwards or out, they would rotate our heads back forward. They pulled our skin taut and knotted it right here at the belly button. Genitalia, too, were moved to the front, so if we wanted to, you know, we could. And most important, they left us with a memory. It was a longing for that original other half of ourselves, the boy or the girl who used to make us whole. And that longing is still so deep in all of us, men for men for women for each other, that it has been the lot of humans ever since to travel the world looking for our other half. And when, says Aristophanes, when one of us meets another, we recognize each other right away. We just know this. We're lost in an amazement of love and friendship and intimacy. We won't get out of each other's sight, even for a moment. These are people, he says, who pass their whole lives together, and yet if you ask them, they could not explain what they desire of each other. They just do.
Thank you. Hello. Hi. Hello. How are you going?
Well, thanks.
That's good. Hello.
G'day.
How are you going?
Good, buddy. How are you?
Yeah, good, thanks. Hello. Hi. Hi. How are you going? That's good. Hey, how are you going? Yeah, you. You good?
Good.
Good. That's good. Oh my goodness, hi. Hello. I didn't see you there. G'day. G'day. How are you going? Not that long.
You joined the chat.
Good. That's good. That's good. Yeah, I'm good. Good. Thanks for asking. Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Hello. How you going? Hey, hi. How you going? Hello. How you going? Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Yeah, really good, thanks. Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Yeah, I'm good. Good, thanks. Yeah, I'm good. Good, 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 thanks. Yeah, I'm good. Hi, how are you going? Hi, how you going? Hi, how you going? Hey, hi, how you going? You good? You good? That's good. Yeah, but I'm good, thanks. Yeah, I'm really good, thanks. I'm good, yeah. Really good, thanks. I'm really good. Hi, how you going? Yeah, good, thanks. Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Hi, hi, how you going? Yeah, I'm
hi, how you going? Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Yeah, really good. Yeah, good. Yeah, couldn't be better. Thanks for asking. Hi, how you going? You good? I'm good. It's good to hear. Oh, not bad, not bad. Getting there. Pretty good. Yeah, actually. I'm really good. Really good. Hi. How you going? Hi, how are you? I'm good, thanks. Yeah, I'm really good. Oh, hey, how are you? Good, good. I'm really good. Really, really good, thanks. Yep, really good. Oh, hi. Yeah, how are you? Good? Yeah. Hi, how you going? Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Yeah, can't complain. Kids good? Yep. Family's good. What about you? G'day. Yeah, good, thanks. You? Yeah, pretty good. Yeah, can't complain, you know. Yeah, good. What about you? Yeah, good, thanks. Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, pretty good. Hey. Hey, how are you? You good? Yeah. Oh, that's rude. I'm great, actually. Actually, yeah, I'm great. Doing really well. Hey, how are you going? Oh, good, good. That's good, yeah. No, me? Yeah. Yeah, pretty good, actually. Yeah, well. I really couldn't complain. Yeah, I'm good. Hey, you well? Ah, oh, that's good. Good. Yeah, no, good, thanks. Thanks. Hi. Thanks for coming. How are you? Good, excellent. I'm good. Thanks for asking. Hi, how are you? Good, I've been good. Yeah, great, thanks. Good, yeah, good. Hey, how's things? Good? Oh, good, good. Yeah, I've been pretty good, thank you. Yeah, things are good, good. How have you been? Good? Yeah, good, that's great. Yeah, I've been good, thanks. Good, good, Hi, how you going? Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, great. Good, thanks. How are you? How are you? How are you going? Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, I'm great, thanks. Really, really good. Hi, how are you? Yeah, I'm really, really good. Been pretty busy. What about you? Yeah, good. Great. How are you? Good, thanks. Yeah, really, really good. I've been really good. How about you? Hi, how are you?
Hi, how are you?
Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Yeah, great, thanks.
Hey, how are things? Yeah, I'm good. Great. Excellent. Thank you. Hiya. How are things? Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, really good, thanks. Great. Thanks.
Hey, how you doing? Hey, how you going? How you going? You good? I'm really good, thanks. Really busy at the moment. Really busy. So busy. Lots on, lots of work.
As I was saying, really, really good. Thank you for asking. Really well. And you, how are you going? You good?
Yeah, Pete's busy and feeling really successful. Like, I've got so much on at the moment. I've got, you know, like, I've been doing a lot of work and there's a lot of...
How you going? Yeah, I'm good. Yep. Thanks for asking. Great. Really, really good.
Feeling on top of the world. King of the world, actually. So busy, you know, there's so much going on at the moment. I haven't got time to think. I haven't got time to catch up with friends and stuff.
Yes, as I was saying... Really good. Busy, good, great. Thanks, yeah.
So busy, I haven't really got time to walk the dogs. Do you know, I've got four dogs living in my house at the moment. Four. And the cat's stuck in...
Yeah, oh look, I'm good. Yeah, all good, thanks.
The cat's stuck in a box upstairs because there's four dogs downstairs. Poor cat.
Hello, how are you? It's so good to see you.
I suppose you're wondering why have I got four dogs? Why have I got four dogs? Do you want to know why I've got four dogs? Because I've got my ex-boyfriend living in my house on bike.
Hi, how are you? Yeah, I'm really good, thanks. Great, thank you.
But I'm not going to go into details. I'm just going to tell you that it's really hard when you're really, really busy and you haven't got time to do anything, to do the dishes and to walk the dogs and to vacuum the carpet. Because you've got a layer of dog fur all over it. Because some dickhead went and got in trouble with the police and is now on bail. At my house, couldn't exactly ever go to prison, could I? You know, he didn't really do much wrong. He's just got mixed up with the wrong crowd.
Thank you. isn't it? Probably.
Questions and learning, I just kind of fake. I don't know what's going on. I don't know why, like to please, to impress, to be liked. It just frustrates me so much because I just end up doing a whole lot of stuff really kind of half-assed. It's made me so angry. I just want to give the whole world the finger that kind of behind my back, so I don't want to see what it would look like if it all came out.
I really hate how I forget things. I'll be in the middle of a conversation with someone and I'll forget the name of some object or something, and I'll have to stop and start describing what I'm talking about, and hopefully they just get what I'm talking about so I can continue the conversation. I really wish I could remember things.
Oh, I really hurt.
Getting older. Have to look after myself a bit more.
There's something I get a bit embarrassed about. It's a bit tricky to talk about. Well, it's not, I just get embarrassed. I hate having too much cleavage. You know, my sister says you should be proud of it, but no, I just want to hide it. So there's some things I like about myself. I like that I'm smart, that I'm really smart. I had an intelligence test once, and the result was that my intelligence was very superior. I like that. Very superior. I am very superior. I do have a little secret. It's not anything to be embarrassed about. It's just that ever since I was a little girl, and to be truthful, even now, when I blow out birthday candles on my cake, I always wish that I could be magic. So,
I hate my legs. I don't know why. I think it's because I'm really short and, you know, you can't grow taller, can you? You can't stretch yourself out. Stupid. I have a lot of ideas that I don't do anything about. And I swear like a sailor. I hate my gigantic phone. I hate that it feels like this beaming light that everyone's staring at, but really probably no one actually is. I wish I was more outgoing. I wish I could just go up to a group of people and start talking to them and feel okay about it and not be wondering what they're thinking about the whole time. I guess it's because I don't like to show my...
I drive myself nuts. If only I would spend the amount of time and energy actually doing what I need to do instead of thinking about it and worrying about it, going round and round in circles in my head, everything would probably be all right. I just need better self-discipline to actually, you know, live the life that I want to live, go to bed early, eat properly, exercise more, all of that stuff, get all my work done. It makes me really angry. And most people don't really know how angry I get. I go out of my way not to show.
So I wasn't here when they said this bit, but I was supposed to say something about drinking and anger and my parenting, but I was kind of hoping I'd get out of it.
So I'm terrible at making decisions. I go over conversations in my head, over and over and over again. Could I have said something different? Could I have done something different? I hate that I have no control over what goes on the inside of my body. But I love that even in the darkest of times, most of the time, I can smile.
So I get angry, and I mean really, really angry. Apparently I even rant. And I'm not very good at saying no to people. I wish I was better at saying no to people. And I hate my fate. I really hate my fate.
It's not entirely the dog's fault that my house is untidy. I actually hate that I get a little bit dysfunctional and overwhelmed sometimes. I get quite paralysed. And I wish my career had been a whole lot different, but I guess there's something about me that hasn't happened that way. And I think I have this amazing ability to attract retarded, psychopathic, loser boyfriends. On the bright side though, I reckon I look pretty good for 46. And I do have a monster cock. Backyard with the chickens.